Hello everyone, welcome to Basics e-learning. In lesson number 4 video, I am going to explain the remaining properties of Fourier series. In my previous lectures, I have explained the basics of signals and systems and numericals based on that, Z-transforms and properties of Z-transforms, problems based on Z-transforms completely. All the questions that I have collected are from previous question papers. Also, there are few lectures on network analysis, the link of which I am going to provide in the description box. Please check it out. Also, students who need online classes can contact us through the mail ID mentioned in the description box. Please check it out. In part 1 video of properties of Fourier series, I have explained the derivations of linearity, time shift, frequency shift and scaling property. And in this video, I am continuing with the time differentiation, time domain convolution, modulation and Parseval's theorem. So let us start. So the fifth property here is time differentiation property. If you do differentiation in time domain signal, what happens to the Fourier series signal in the frequency domain? That is going to explain by this time differentiation property. So let us see. Suppose if x of t has the time difference, x of t is the time domain signal and its Fourier series signal is x of k, then if you do the differentiation in time domain, that is d by dt of x of t, then the Fourier series signal of the whole, this part, right, the after differentiation, whatever you are getting, that let us call that as y of t, right? So for that it is given by j k omega naught x of k, right? Now let us see the proof. Just write down the definition. So you know x of t can be expressed as, x of t can be expressed as sigma k is running from minus infinity to infinity x of k e power j k omega naught t, right? So previous videos I have explained only x of k, that means the Fourier series. Now this is inverse Fourier series formula. Inverse Fourier series means if you know x of k, how to write x of t. So here x of t is your time domain signal, where x of k is your frequency domain signal. So once you know your Fourier series of x of t, then you can express this as summation of k running from minus infinity to infinity x of k e power j k omega naught t. Now go with the differentiation. So differentiate with respect to t on x of t. So d by dt of x of t here is, so I am doing on both the sides differentiation. K is running from minus infinity to infinity. X of k will be a constant because this term is not having any dependency on t, right? So this will come out. So e power j k omega naught t, right? So this is having t term, right? So then you will get what? J k omega naught, right? So e power j k omega naught multiplied by j k omega naught, because as you are differentiating this term, right? So that means d by dt of e power j k omega naught t. So you know e power theta is theta only, e power theta only, right? So d by dx of e power x means e power x you will get, but I have this term extra. So that's why that will come out. E j k omega naught multiplied by e power j k omega naught t. So I am writing this as sigma k is running from minus infinity to infinity j k omega naught x of k multiplied by e power j k omega naught t, right? So if you compare this with the standard formula of your inverse Fourier series, if you see here x of t and is expressed as sigma k is running from minus infinity to infinity x of k e power j k omega naught t. Here x of t and x of k are Fourier series pair, means x of k is the Fourier series of x of t. Now coming to this line here, this is nothing but d by dt of x of t here is equal to sigma k is running from minus infinity to infinity jk omega naught x of k multiplied by e power jk omega naught. So if you compare here, that is equation number 1 and 2, instead of x of k, I have this much, that is jk omega naught x of k. Instead of x of t, I have this one, d by dt of x of t. Means here, d by dt x of t and jk omega naught x of k are Fourier series pair. That means d by dt of x of t has a Fourier series of jk omega naught x of k. So this is nothing but your differentiation property. So if you do the differentiation of a time domain signal d by dt of x of t, the Fourier series signal, the basic Fourier series signal x of k is multiplied by jk omega naught on each frequency scale. Let us see time domain convolution. So you're taking two signals x of t and y of t in time domain. Let us say x of k and y of k are their Fourier series signals respectively. Then if you're doing convolution in time domain, that is x of t convolution y of t, let us call it as z of t. If you apply Fourier series of such signal, you are going to get z of k, that is equal to t into x of k into y of k. Let us see the derivation of this time domain convolution property. Before going to start the derivation of this time domain convolution, one should know what is the convolution. So time domain convolution x of t convolution y of t is given by integral over L x of L y of t minus L dl. So generally in your textbook, this in place of L, they may give tau, that is in your module 2 LTI systems. So in Fourier series, they're taking it as L to avoid the confusion with the nomenclature, right? The symbols. Now we'll see the proof. Let us say the signals x of t, y of t, z of t all are having the same time period capital T, which is given by 2 pi by omega naught, right? So now let us take this z of k. That means I'm applying Fourier series to this z of t. So I'm just writing down the formula 1 by t integral over t z of t e power minus jk omega naught t dt. So by this point of time, the student has to be familiar with the Fourier series formula 1 by t integral over t z of t e power minus jk omega naught t dt. And here z of t is nothing but convolution of x of t and y of t. Let us substitute that here. So I'm writing 1 by t integral over t in place of z of t, I'm writing x of t convolution y of t e power minus jk omega naught t dt. So replace this x of t convolution y of t with the expansion, that is the basic formula. So I'm writing here, that means this one, take it as equation number 1. So I'm substituting equation number 1 here. So integral over L x of L y of t minus L dl, then as usual the remaining part you can write down, e power minus jk omega naught t dt. Be careful when you are writing the derivation, when you are doing the derivation, because you have so many terms here, capital T, L, small t, k, omega naught, everything is there, right? So be careful when you are writing this one. Now let us change the order of integration. So for that, I'm taking t minus L as m. So take differentiation on both the sides. So dt, anyhow, this will be 0 as L is not having any dependency on t. So dt is equal to dm. So let us do that. what you are going to get here is 1 by t integral over L. First you write it like this, integral over L, x of L you write it outside because it is not depending. Then integral over t, only t dependency I am writing inside, e power minus j k omega naught t dt and dl I have, right? So this much, this I am just changing the order here. Now you write the, now you change the order of integration. So what I am getting here is 1 by t, in place of dt I am writing dm, and in place of t minus l I am writing m. So this will be integral l x of l integral over m. That means I'm changing the order of integration to m, because what, t minus l is equal to m, right? So y of m e power minus j k omega naught t is nothing but m plus l now, right? Because as I'm assuming t minus l is equal to m, then t is equal to m plus l. That you can change it, m plus l. Now no t here, right? Dt you can replace this as dm into dl, right? So this is one integration, and then this is another integration. That means integral over m, this part, right? Integral over l and this part, right? Now I am just changing the terms into two parts, that is 1 by t integral over l x of l. This part I have, so let us write it, then I'll explain. Integral over m y of m, this e power term I'm splitting. See, jk omega naught m multiplied by e power minus jk omega naught l dm dl. Now change the terms and write down into two separate integrals. So that means what I am getting is 1 by t integral over l x of l e power minus jk omega naught l dl. All l terms I am writing together, and then I have integral over m y of m e power minus jk omega naught m dm, right? Now changing the order of summation and integration, the same z of k, I am just writing it as 1 by t, right? So this I have sigma, l is running from minus infinity to infinity x of l, right? So that x of l is nothing but Fourier series of x of t. We have replaced x of t with the synthesis equation, right? So that I am writing sigma, l is running from minus infinity to infinity x of l I am writing out. Then integral over t, y of t, the rest all the terms I am writing here. As you have e power terms, two e power terms are there, e power jl omega naught t and e power minus jk omega naught t. I am just combining both of them, e power minus jk minus l omega naught t dt. So if you observe this part, that is the integration part, so this is nothing but the Fourier series formula, y of t e power jk omega naught t dt. But instead of jk, I have k minus l. So if you have only k, then you will be writing it as y of k. But I have k minus l, so this term you have to write it as y of k minus l. And the front part I am just copying down, 1 by t integral over l is running from minus infinity, sigma l is running from minus infinity to infinity x of l multiplied by y of k minus l. So if you observe, this is nothing but the expansion of your integration, right? So that is nothing but here convolution, sorry. So that is nothing but x of k convolution y of k, right? So this is nothing but z of k is equal to x of k convolution y of k. This is the formula for convolution, as I have explained in the previous property also. 1 by t sigma, k is running from minus infinity to infinity, any variable you can take, right? So here they have taken it as l, L is running from minus infinity to infinity. X of L, Y is running from Y of K minus L. So, what the student has to understand is, the multiplication in time domain goes to convolution in property domain, whereas the convolution in time domain goes to multiplication in frequency domain. Coming to property number 7, modulation property. This is also known as multiplication theorem. Here, let us take two signals x of t and y of t. And x of k and y of k are their frequency domain signals after application of Fourier series. If you multiply these two signals in time domain, that is x of t into z of t, x of t into y of t, then the frequency domain signal, that means after application of Fourier series, it will be x of k convolution y of k. Means if you compare with the previous property, the convolution in time domain goes to multiplication in frequency domain, whereas multiplication in time domain goes to convolution in frequency domain. So let us see the proof here. Let us take the Fourier series of z of t. I'm just writing down the formula. Z of k is equal to integral 1 by t integral t z of t e power minus j k omega naught t dt. So what is z of t that we have assumed as x of t into y of t. So just replace z of t with x of t multiplied by y of t. Then you write the rest, e power minus j k omega naught t dt. Now we have to assume here that what is x of t and what is y of t, right? So from you can write down the synthesis equation here, that is x of t can be expressed, the Fourier series, right? X of t can be expressed, any signal in time domain can be expressed as the summation of these signals, x of l e power j l omega naught t. That means I am writing just the inverse Fourier series of your x of t. Similarly, that y of t also. I am just replacing x of t and y of t with the inverse Fourier series formula. Right. First, you replace this x of t. Then we can write for y of t. Right. So that what happens here is integral over t. In place of x of t, I am writing means that will be sigma L is running from minus infinity to infinity x of L e power j L omega naught t multiplied by y of t e power minus j k omega naught t dt. If you observe, I have just replaced this x of t with this formula, the synthesis formula or inverse Fourier series formula. Now, changing the order of summation and integration, the same z of k, I'm just writing it as 1 by t, right? So this I have sigma, L is running from minus infinity to infinity x of L, right? So that x of L is nothing but Fourier series of x of t. We have replaced x of t with the synthesis equation, right? So that I'm writing sigma, L is running from minus infinity to infinity x of L I'm writing out. Then integral over t, y of t, the rest all the terms I am writing here. As you have e power terms, two e power terms are there, e power j l omega naught t and e power minus j k omega naught t. I am just combining both of them, e power minus j k minus l omega naught t dt. So if you observe this part, that is the integration part, so this is nothing but the Fourier series formula, y of t e power j k omega naught t dt. But instead of j k, I have k minus l. So if you have only k, then you will be writing it as y of k. But I have k minus l. So this term you have to write it as y of k minus l. And the front part I'm just copying down, 1 by t integral over L is running from minus infinity, sigma L is running from minus infinity to infinity, x of L multiplied by y of k minus L. So if you observe, this is nothing but the expansion of your integration, right? So that is nothing but here convolution, sorry. So that is nothing but x of k convolution y of k, right? So this is nothing but z of k is equal to x of k convolution y of k. This is the formula for convolution, as I have explained in the previous property also. 1 by t, sigma k is running from minus infinity to infinity, any variable you can take, right? So here they have taken it as L. L is running from minus infinity to infinity, x of L, y is running from y of k minus L. So what the student has to understand is, the multiplication in time domain goes to convolution in property domain, whereas the convolution in time domain goes to multiplication in frequency domain. The last property is Parseval's theorem in Fourier series. Always this Parseval's theorem gives you the average power of the signal. Let us say x of t be some power signal. So the average power of the signal is given by t is equal to 1 by t integral over t x of t whole square dt in your time domain. This you know, already I have explained in the channel also in the first module. So if you express the power signal, power average power of the signal in frequency domain, what happens, we'll see. That is given by sigma k is running from minus infinity to infinity x of k whole square, where x of k is the Fourier series of the signal x of t. So let us see the proof here. So you know, power of the signal is given by 1 by t integral magnitude of x of t whole square dt. This is the basic time domain average power signal, right? So this, as you have modulus and square, this can be written as x of t and multiplied by x conjugate of t dt, right? So you know the synthesis equation. I am just replacing again 1 x of t with the synthesis equation. That is nothing but your Fourier series, right? So the Fourier series formula, inverse Fourier series formula, is given by x of t is equal to sigma k is running from minus infinity to infinity x of k e power j k omega naught t, right? So this x of t you replace with the synthesis equation. Similarly, x star of t also, right? The conjugate of x also is given by sigma k is running from minus infinity to infinity x star of t, x star of k e power j k omega naught t. But as you have star here, this minus will come. Understood? So first we will replace this x star of t with the synthesis equation, and then we'll replace x of t also. Let us do that. So here p is given by 1 by t integral. I am writing x of t as usual. First you replace x star of t with the inverse Fourier series formula or synthesis equation. So that will be sigma k is running from minus infinity to infinity x star of k e power minus j k omega naught t. Right. Then you have that dt. In place of dt, that same thing I have copied. Now what happens, we'll see. So you just change the order of this summation and integration. So that means the sigma part, I am writing it out. 1 by t, sigma k is running from minus infinity to infinity x star of k. You write it outside. Then you write the summation here. Integral x of t e power minus j k omega naught t dt. What is this one? X of t e power minus j k omega naught t dt. This is nothing but your x of k, right? Fourier series formula. So directly you are getting sigma k is running from minus infinity to infinity. No need to write down your inverse Fourier series. Directly you got the Fourier series formula itself. So that time domain signal converted into your frequency domain signal. So you know, a signal multiplied by its conjugate, this can be written as here as 1 by t also will come in the formula. So 1 by t will not come in picture here. So this will be sigma k is running from minus infinity to infinity magnitude of x of k whole square. Right? Understood this part, right? 1 by t integral x of t e power minus jk omega naught t dt is nothing but the basic Fourier series formula. So that I have replaced this with x of k. So the average power of any signal is nothing but in the frequency domain is given by k is running from minus infinity to infinity x of k whole square. So if you plot the values of this x of k whole square on the graph sheet, right, like x of k square on the y-axis and k on x-axis, you will be obtaining a line spectrum of the power in the waveform, and this is known as the power spectrum density of the given signal x of t. For more videos, please do like, share, subscribe to our channel. Let us know your suggestions and queries in the comment box. Thank you.